Hey everyone, Matt Jarbo here with evilavatar.com. I'm going to give you guys a tour of the Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning, or from here on out, I'm just going to be calling it The Reckoning, for the Xbox 360. Now, this is a game that, just a little bit of a backstory with it, I'm just going to get into it as I tell it. I was at Comic-Con a couple years ago, and they had a panel for this game, and it was, you know, Todd McFarlane was there, R.A. Salvatore was there, the guy who was like the one of the game directors of fucking Skyrim was, or sorry, Oblivion was there, and they were talking about this game. And at first my friends and I were like, oh, this sounds kind of cool. And then we went to a panel again the following year and checked it out again. And then it kind of dropped off the map, but here we got a demo. So at the request of Evil Avatar himself, Mr. Phil Hansen, I'm doing my thoughts, a video on my thoughts of the game. I'm going to play casual because it's just normal because I have to. Okay, so I'm just going to skip ahead. No, I'm not going to skip. I'll go back. As we'll start from the beginning again. So this game seems pretty cool. It's getting a lot of interesting chatter online, mostly due to the fact that it's very similar to Fable in regards of like style and setting and situation and whatnot. But it's also kind of getting, you know, like shit on by some because people believe that it's too similar to Fable. Not to mention the fact that it's also very, it's very MMO-ish, and people don't really want the MMO situation. You know, they're like, oh, I don't want an MMO on a console. I don't want a game that looks like this, blah, blah, blah. Personally, I think it's pretty fucking dope. I really like this right here. Like, you know, a lot of colors, a lot of nice dynamic lighting. It gives a nice feel for the world while maintaining almost a cartoonish animated look, which I really like. You know, and there's a girl with two arrows in her chest. How often does that happen? Uh-oh, some dudes getting killed. Hey, what's up, guy? Nope. Decapitations and blood. Obviously a flame blade, right? So, there's gonna be a lot of violence in this game. I like that. So, I mean, you look at a game like this and you think, like, okay, it's got an interesting setup, which they have to have, you know, it's like a very Lord of the Rings-esque setup. Kind of similar to what you saw in the first movie. Here he goes. You dead. Oh, no, I'm dead. Wow. What the fuck kind of goatee is that? Women, don't ever let a guy with a goatee made of, like, embers eat you out. It's just not going to work. But anyway, because this is, I'm sorry, this video is very not safe for work. My commentary tracks are never safe for work. But no, I mean, if you look at the original Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring, they had that, like, you know, 4 or 5 minute prologue that really set the world up and showed you what the characters are going to be doing. And this is very similar in it the same regard, which I like because it makes you really kind of take back. It actually allows you the opportunity to get the background of this world without giving too much away. So, you know, it's the Feylands and there's different sections to this world. And this one, it's only, you're in the Kingdom of Amalur and you're going to be in the Feylands is where this game takes place. And of course, I think from what I've read, there's like 5 other places that you're going to be allowed to go to as the game progresses, like as the series progresses, provided it does well. So now, of course, we're going to get into the main part of the game, which is where, you know, your character is dead, you know, which I thought was, I actually like this, the fact that they're able to reanimate dead bodies, and that's kind of where you come from, you know, and I think that's kind of cool. But another thing I want to talk about, because we're still in the first few minutes of this video, is the fact that there was a story on Joystick about how they got an early copy of this game, and inside there was an online pass, and the online pass, all right, who am I going to be? Be a chick, be a dude. I always play as a guy. I'm going to play as a chick this time. All right. Almain, Varani, I don't know, Lufsar, Dakalafar. Okay, it was this one here. All right, she's more of like a fighter, pirate or mercenary, kind of cool. See, she's like an elf. And she's like a dark elf, so to speak. All right, I'm going to go with the pirate and or mercenary. Let's see. All right, because it's kind of cool. You get to pick fire. See, what I like is if you look at this right here, it gives you +6 fire damage, +6 fire resistance, or you get +6 ice, +6 ice resistance, physical damage. Huh. All right, I'm gonna go with death because I dislike that. All right, what's she look like? Eh. Meh. Nah. Hmm. Eh. Kind of like she looks angry with those scars. She's kind of cute. I like redheads. What? Oh yeah, we go with that. And I'm just gonna randomize it because I don't want to go through it. No. Nah. Eh. What? She from Portland, Oregon? Yeah, she's from Portland, Oregon. All right, we're gonna go with her. So anyway, the joystick story was saying that they had an online pass, and the people are now bad-mouthing the online pass because they're going like, they're cutting out content from the game. How dare they? You know, it's okay. Keep in mind, this is published by EA, so this kind of shit is to be expected. However, with this particular, you know, situation, because I just read an update before coming and doing this, the content, the quest lines that are going to be from the online pass are for new buyers. It was content that was not originally put on the disc, or it was going to be on the disc and then they cut it because it wasn't finished. So it was going to be the first DLC. So if you buy it new, you technically get DLC for free. So, okay, that's not so bad. Are they probably going to charge like $10 for the quest line? Isolde is a good name. I don't really feel like changing it, but I'm gonna. We're just gonna do a quick one. Tits. Me. Come on, where's that at? Alright, her name is Tits. Sorry, ladies. I was gonna do Tits McGee from Anchor Man, but they won't let me do it. So, bastards. But anyway, I don't really see the problem with that. I mean, if you know, a quest line was removed because it wasn't going to be part of the game, and then they decided to make it part of the game, okay, that's fine. If they had just had it on the disc and then cut it from the disc, or do what, I don't know, Gears of War 3 did, or Battlefield 3 did, or other games where they had it on the disc and you had to pay $10 for 180 kilobyte unlock code. That's what they did in those games, so that was fucked up. If this game's like that, I'd be pissed off. But I don't know. We're not talking about that. We're talking about the game itself. Okay. So here we go. Here is Tits. She has gotten up. She's walking on a pile of corpses, trying to keep her bearings and everything. All right. So, yeah, let's get on with this. This is, like, the only thing I hate about, like, this is the problem with this game I've noticed is it's wordy, like, more wordy than me, and I talk a lot, but it's wordy. And it's one of those games where it's very, you know, you have to do a lot of reading or you got to listen to a lot of stuff. The last time I played through it, because this is my second time playing through it, I was kind of like, I don't want to say bored, but I was put off by some of the small stuff. So it's getting a feel for the controls here. A is sprint. Okay, X is dodge. Find my way out. All right. See, here's another thing. This is one thing that Phil and I were talking about. All right, let's see. I'm not going to go through this. Basically, it says that they're finding dead bodies and finding a way to reanimate them. That's what it's doing. Oh, look at this. What can I interact with here? Oh, I incinerated this person. Little things like that are kind of cool where you have the ability to, you know, you have the ability to interact with the world a little bit. Okay, I'm going to take the rusty longsword, which I think is a sexual term in India. All right, going to inventory, weapons, primary, rusty longsword, equip. That's a big ass longsword. Look at that sucker. That thing's insane. Okay. Let's go into the world. All right, so we're here. There's some guys. Oh no. Wow, that fucking sucks. It was like a dwarf and he's just like getting punted off of a bridge. All right, so as you can see, the detail to the world is quite nice. I think this part right here, when I played it before, I kind of commented on this one. The way I look at this right here is this is definitely making fun of any damn ass RPG that comes out where the first thing you kill on these kind of games are cave rats, sewer rats, rats of some size, you know, rats of an inordinary size or whatever they said from Princess Bride. But that's like, this game does really rip off a lot of the other kind of like dungeon crawler RPGs. I felt like I played a lot of like Baldur's Gate, Dark Alliance was a bit from this and other things as well. And I just kind of look at it like, you know, like it's a new franchise, and so there's stuff that they got to do. Okay, yeah, really, I don't want to. Okay. Bam, sucker! Oh, what? What? You dead? Yeah, I love the fact that I get a kill. Oh, you dick! You ain't dead. Now you dead. One hit. I love games like this where it's like, oh, I'm going to totally just, you know, kill all these guys. All right, I'm just gonna skip this. Oh, you're alive! Oh my god! Okay, I'm not dead. All right. Select it. Okay. Here's where they tell you that you came from the Well of Souls. Your soul was returned to your body. Yada, yada, yada. You gotta go find Professor Hughes. Yada, yada, yada. Okay. How do I get out? No doubt. There's questions. Oh, questions. Questions. Goodbye. I mean, I should have probably gone back to that. What they do there is when you get into these question trees, is like you have the ability to really kind of ask a lot of questions. And it's like, okay, you get that ability. Cool. It's kind of like, you know. Wait. Oh, there's some underwear. You see that? Underwear. All right. Why can't I run around in underwear? That'd be kind of cool. That's kind of sexist to not let the player run around naked, because that's what you do in games like this. Metal Gear Solid 2, I'm talking to you. But anyway, the dialogue tree allows you to really like ask, and they give you a lot of options. So the writers really put a lot of time and effort into the idea that, you know, you want to get to know this world. Shit's blowing up. There's obviously souls. All right. I love this. This is kind of cool. Bodies floating in the water. And you don't see a lot of that, really, in these kind of games where they actually show like things like this where stuff gets fucked up and people are dead. You know. But it's definitely nice attention to detail. I like the dungeon layout. They said there's 150 dungeons in the games, and all of them are handcrafted, and not one of them repeats. They didn't do what Skyrim did and give it a you know, kind of a repeating dungeon set. All right. See, some of these things can be destroyed. This is where it gets kind of tedious. It's like, oh hey, I want money, so I'm just gonna destroy all these things, and that gives me money, and I really don't care because I don't really worry about it. All right, loot weapons rack. Okay, take the shield. Let's equip the shield. The demo is very straightforward. It doesn't really allow for a lot of like exploration. It's very linear in the first section of this game, and that's. Let's see, here we go. Okay, sword. All right, if I can block it. Bam, bam. Sucker! Oh! Shit. See, but it's like, they strike me, and they don't do anywhere near as a lot of damage, so it's definitely, you know, I don't know. It's, these are also first enemies, so they're pretty straightforward and pretty easy to kill, so I'm not too worried about it, but, alright, let's just, this demo is very long in terms of, where you have to go, and just to get through this first section, like, I honestly thought that this is gonna take a while. All right, secondary crude birch longbow. Okay, so here's what I like. This is kind of cool when it comes to the actual combat in the game, is the fact that you have, you know, like X is your sword or your primary weapon, and then you can use your, oh shit, ah fucker. You know, you see Y would go to your secondary, and then it's like, where, shoot the what? Where the, oh, here we go. Okay, so, you know, and then when you get magic, it's like, hold on right trigger. See this right here? I'm holding on the right trigger, and you can map stuff, and that becomes your magic. So that works out pretty cool, because it allows you to really change up your combat styles on the fly. And that works really well for, I think, the type of game they want to have. Oh, two dudes. One dead. All right. So I'm just rushing through.